Welcome and thank you for taking the necessary steps to become a Middleton Baseball and Softball Commission authorized facility manager. The MBSC is proud of its 8,000 square foot indoor practice facility at Firefighters Memorial Park in Middleton. This video is intended to orient coaches who oversee indoor practices and to outline expectations for the proper use of the facility. To become an authorized facility manager, a coach shall pass a background check, review and sign the facility operating guidelines, attend an in-person orientation, or watch this video and take an online test. The use of the indoor practice facility is intended for registered MBSC players, as well as Middleton High School baseball and softball players. When in use, an authorized facility manager shall be present at all times.
Grab a partner.
Safety shall be everyone's primary goal. A facility manager shall ensure that there is sufficient space available for all training activities to be conducted in a safe manner. Players need to ensure that the individual they are throwing to is paying attention at all times. Use caution and stand clear from all nettings as they give way. Individuals can easily be struck by baseballs or softballs as they come into contact with the net. Bats should not be on the turf unless the player is actively involved in an organized hitting drill, preferably inside a batting cage. All family members and visitors must remain in the waiting area and are not allowed on the field turf. Fire exits must remain clear of obstructions at all times. Fire extinguishers are labeled and located near both emergency exit doors. The walkway behind the waiting area and the netting must remain clear as an egress path in the event of an emergency. In the event of minor injuries, a first aid kit is located inside the equipment room. All facility managers shall have access to a charged cell phone at all times while on site. In the event of an emergency, call 911. It is a facility manager's responsibility to ensure that all players, coaches, and guests adhere to the rules posted just inside the entryway. Upon completion of all facility manager requirements, a coach will be authorized to receive a unique PIN code to access the facility. This access code shall not be shared with others, as facility members are not authorized to designate other coaches to lead a practice unless direct consent has been provided by the Middleton Baseball and Softball Commission. Players may store personal equipment and clothing in the designated waiting area. Appropriate footwear and clothing should be exchanged inside the waiting area and prior to entering the field turf practice area. It is everyone's responsibility to ensure that the bathrooms remain stocked with paper towels and toilet paper. All bathroom supplies are stored in the equipment room. There are two separately controlled heating units located on opposite ends of the facility. Do not set the temperature above 68 degrees and return thermostats to 52 degrees for unoccupied use. During warm weather operations, the large overhead door can be opened to provide cross ventilation. Upon completing the requirements to become an authorized facility manager, an access code is provided for equipment room access. All equipment shall be returned to its designated area and neatly stored after each use. The equipment room should be locked following a practice if another workout isn't scheduled to immediately take place. MBSC players and coaches have the benefit of utilizing various stationary and mobile equipment. Additional instruction on specific pieces of equipment may be necessary in the event a coach hasn't had previous experience or training. A coach should not use any piece of equipment that they are not familiar with. Requesting additional instruction or shadowing other MBSC coaches trained in the proper use of equipment is highly recommended. General use rules should be followed at all times in order to help better maintain the quality and longevity of the equipment. Plastic tees are for use by all players under the age of 13. Tanner tees can be easily damaged by not making contact with the ball and therefore are for the exclusive use of players 13 years and over. Coaches should not allow players to hang on nets due to unnecessary stress and damage it may cause. Equipment should not be stored against the padded north wall to prevent damage and to minimize unpredictable deflections. Use extreme caution when setting up, utilizing or transitioning equipment to prevent any unnecessary wear and tear. In order to prevent damage to the field turf, practice mats should be utilized anywhere there is repetitive motion. Home plate mats, as well as repetitive motion and pitching mats, should not be rolled as they will begin to curl and become a trip hazard. The key to an effective and safe practice is the proper utilization of equipment through coordinated drill sets. The MBSC recommends shadowing experienced MBSC coaches to enhance your players' practice experience and to better utilize the equipment made available to all MBSC athletes.
All right, throw your change-up grip now, all right? Same thing. This should be the same mechanics.
When an authorized facility manager is scheduled to utilize the facility immediately following a practice, efforts should be made to coordinate what can be left out and what will need to be returned to its designated storage area. The authorized facility manager is responsible for ensuring that the building and equipment have been returned to ready status and sign out stating that they have done so to the level and expectation set forth by the MBSC. Facility contact information is located on the sign-out form in the event any known issues need to be reported. Prior to exiting the building, ensure that the sidewalk leading to the facility is accessible during winter months and that the exterior grounds are kept clean and presentable. Shut off all lights upon exiting the facility and check to ensure that the building is locked and secure. Upon completion of this video, select the link to the online test to complete the requirements to become an MBSC authorized facility manager. Thank you for being a part of the MBSC program. For more information regarding the Middleton Baseball and Softball Commission, visit www.mbscwi.com.